Hello students, in last class you have learnt about what are the uses and what are the properties of timber. Okay, today we will see what are the classification of tree and what is the structure of a tree. Okay, as we get timber from the tree, so today we will see what are its classification and what is the structure of a tree. Okay, first is classification of trees. Okay, depending upon the growth of the trees, the trees has classified into two categories. One is exogenous trees and second one is endogenous trees. Okay, so exogenous trees means the trees which are the trees which increases in bulk by growing outwards. Okay, the trees grows in outwards. Okay, the branches will grow in the outwards. Okay, these are means these trees grows in a bulk. Okay, so these exogenous trees are mainly used in the civil engineering field. Okay, as the timber from these trees are very useful in the civil engineering field. Okay, so second one is endogenous trees. Okay, so these endogenous trees grows inwards. Okay, these won't grow outwards and these trees are having the very limited application in the civil engineering field. Okay, and these trees are means these trees grows in inwards and having the fibrous structures. Okay, the main example for these trees is bamboo. Okay, you have already seen the bamboo, so it is having the fibrous structure. Okay, so these trees are having the very limited application in the civil engineering field. Okay, so these are the two categories or two classification of trees depending upon their growth. Next is structure of a tree. Okay, so there are two types of structure. First one is macrostructure and second one is microstructure. Okay, when you cut a tree, you can means the inside structure you can see by the naked eyes. Okay, that structure is called as the macro structure. Okay, the structure of a tree by which you can see by the naked eyes. Okay, you can see it normally means by your eyes you can see that structure. That type of structure is called as the macro structure. Second is microstructure, the structure which you can see only using the microscope. Okay, that much fine means fine structure it is having. So that type of structure by seeing the microscope you can call it as the micro structure. Okay, see, this is the cross section of a exogenous trees. Okay, so when you cut the exogenous trees it will look like this. Okay, this is the cross section of the exogenous tree. Okay, so first part of this cross section of tree is pith. Okay, this is centermost part which is in dark color, you can see. This is called as the pith or medulla. Okay, this is the innermost part of the tree. Next comes heartwood. Okay, this is the heartwood. Okay, the whatever the rings which are surrounded to the pith of the tree is called as the heartwood. Okay, it is normally having the strong portion of the tree. Okay, it is the considered as the most strong and durable portion of the tree and it provides most strong timber for the engineering purposes. Okay, so this heartwood provides best means most strongest or durable timber for the engineering works. Okay, next comes annular rings. Okay, these rings you can see, these rings are called as the annular rings. Okay, these rings predict the age of the trees. Okay, these horizontal means these circles or these rings you can see, these rings are called as the annular rings. Okay, next comes sapwood. Okay, sapwood. Okay, the portion between the heartwood and the cambium layer. Okay, the portion between heartwood and the cambium layer is called as the sapwood. Okay, it doesn't provide any strength to the tree, but it supplies water and minerals to the tree. Okay, which is going to help in growing the tree. Okay, it is very active part in growing the tree. Okay, as it supplies the mineral and water to the tree, so it is a very active part in growing the tree. Okay, next comes cambium layer. Okay, the portion between sapwood and the inner bark, you can see here inner bark. Okay, this is the inner bark and this is the sapwood. Okay, the layer between the inner bark and the sapwood is called as the cambium layer. Okay, cambium layer. Next is inner bark. Okay, the inner bark, it is the layer which protects the cambium layer. Okay, this cambium layer, if it comes, means if it exposed to the atmosphere, there may be chances of decaying of timber, or maybe it may cause any decay of the means effects from the atmospheric agents like any rain, water, or else any insects and fungi. Okay, there may be chances of the attacks of the any bacterias or insects. Okay, so there may be chances of decaying of timber. So to protect that layer, the inner bark is which is going to help to protect this cambium layer. Okay, next is outer bark. Okay, the outermost part of the tree is called as the outer bark. Okay, the outermost layer of the timber or the outermost layer of the tree is called as the outer bark. Okay, these radial lines you can see. Okay, these radial lines are called as the medullary rays. Okay, these radial lines are called as the medullary rays, and these helps in holding these annular rings. Okay, these helps in holding the annular rings. Okay, these are the parts of a tree. When you cut the tree, this is the cross section and these are the parts of the trees. Okay, next comes seasoning of timber. Okay, as I have told you, seasoning is the process of removal of moisture from the timber. Okay, it is the process of removal of water from the freshly cut timber. Okay, why we do seasoning of a timber is to increase the means its strength. Okay, to increase its strength, we have to do the seasoning. Okay, if we remove the moisture from the timber, then it will get the strength as well as the it will get the durability also. So seasoning, we have to do it very carefully. Okay, next, there are methods of seasoning. Okay, there are two types of seasoning we can do First one is natural seasoning and second one is artificial seasoning. Okay. First one is natural seasoning. Okay. In this method, we will make, means we will keep the timbers, freshly cut timbers, in layer wise, and we will make it exposed to the natural air. Okay, when natural air is supplies, and it will make the, means it will remove the moisture from the timber. Okay, it makes the seasons, means it will make the timber to get strength more. Okay, when the moisture is taken out from that, the automatically the timber will, means the timber will be useful for the construction purpose. Okay, so the advantage of natural seasoning is it does not require any skilled supervision. Okay, and this method is very cheap and simple. Okay, as we don't want, means skilled supervision is not required, so it is, it proves as a economical one. Okay, so and as it is having advantages and also it is having the disadvantages also, as it proceed at as it is a natural seasoning process, it takes the more time for seasoning. Okay, next is artificial seasoning. Okay, there are many methods for the artificial seasoning. We will see one by one. First one is boiling. Okay, in this process what we do is we will make the, means we will keep the timber into a immersed water. Okay, we will immerse the trees or timber, sorry, we will immerse the timber into the hot water, or else we will immerse the timber into the water, then we will boil the water. Okay, due to the boiling the timber gets seasoned quickly. Okay, it is also a very, means it is a very expensive process. Okay, it proves the uneconomical process. Okay, next is chemical seasoning. Okay, this is also known as salt seasoning. Okay, in this method what we will do, the timber we will immerse in it a suitable salt solution. Okay, we will add salt into the water, in that water we will immerse the timber into that water, then we will take it out and season it in a ordinary way, means by natural air we will make it seasoned. Okay, so this is also a expensive method. Okay, as it is just a method, means we will add a salt into it and we will make it, we will remove the moisture from the timber. Next is electrical seasoning. Okay, in this method what we will do, high frequency of current is passed through the wood. Okay, current is passed through the wood. Okay, as it current passed through the wood, it generates the more temperature of the heat. Okay, as heat produces, automatically the wood get seasoned. Okay, so that heat removes the moisture from the wood. Okay, so it is very rapid method of seasoning, as well as it is a very costly method of the seasoning. Next is kiln seasoning. Okay, this method is commonly used when seasoning of timber on a large scale has to be done. Okay, large amount of timber you want to season it, that time you can use this kiln seasoning. Okay, in this method though, this is the airtight chamber. Okay, this is the airtight chamber. In this chamber, we are going to means we will arrange the timber in a layer wise, and hot air is supplied through the all the layers of the timber. Okay, when we supply the hot air into the all these layers, that hot air removes the all the moisture from the wood. Okay, so hence it is also a very rapid method of seasoning. Hence it removes the all the moisture by the means very quickly, but it is a very costly method. Okay, as it requires a fully airtight chamber, a hot air, everything, which proves that it is very uneconomical as it requires more money, but it gives the very effective seasoning of the timber. Okay, next is water seasoning. Okay, in this process, the log of wood is completely immersed in a running stream of water. Okay, what we will make, we will keep the water means we will keep the wood into means we will immerse the wood in a running stream water. Okay, we will keep these wood some period of 2 to 4 weeks. Okay, after we will take out all wood from the water. Okay, when we will keep these wood into the water, during this process the sap contained in timber is washed away. Okay, then water gets seasoned, and it is also a quick method, but it reduces the durability of the timber. Okay, it reduces the durability of the timber. Next is solar drying or solar kiln seasoning. Okay, in this method, you can see in this image, the timber is kept into this, and this is the solar panel. Okay, solar heat is collected by a series of black painted solar panels. Okay, it is also a very effective method. Okay, but it is also a very costly method of the seasoning. Okay, these are the types of the, or these are the methods of the artificial seasoning. Okay, these are the very effective methods, but the cost of these methods are the very high. Okay, but natural seasoning gives best seasoning of the timber, but it is takes more time. Okay, these artificial seasoning takes less time to remove the moisture from the timber, but these are the very costly. Okay, as the natural seasoning takes more time to remove the moisture from the timber, but that it gives the more strength to the timber. Okay, in next class we will see the next part of the natural construction material unit. Okay, thank you.